हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम मोहम्मद रफ़ीक़। वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल रफ़ीक़ इंजीनियरिंग ड्राइंग। सो इन द प्रीवियस वीडियोस वी हैव कवर्ड प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ पॉइंट्स, प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ लाइंस। नाउ वी आर एंटरिंग इन द प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ प्लेन्स। सो एज इट इज़ अ फर्स्ट वीडियो, आई वुड लाइक टू गिव सम इंट्रोडक्शन, सम बेसिक्स विच आर नीडेड टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ प्लेन्स प्रॉब्लम्स। ओके, सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी ओनली डिस्कसिंग द बेसिक्स रिलेटेड टू प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ प्लेन्स। ओके, लेट अस सी व्हाट आर द प्लेन्स, हाउ दे विल ask the questions, everything one by one we will see in this video. Okay, let us see here some commonly used planes. There are so many planes. I am talking about mostly or with respect to examination point of view, which is more preferable. It doesn't mean that this only will come in the exam. This is more preferable choice. So what are the planes we will be using in the examination or in the questions? Triangle, square, rectangle, rhombus, pentagon, hexagon and circle. Take out some object from here. Hexagon I have here with me. Hexagon has 6 corners. Okay, if they ask you hexagon problem, how they will ask and what are the terms and things we need to understand in the hexagon, we will see. And how to draw the hexagon, all those things I will discuss while solving the problem. Let us see. XY line. Above the XY line, this VP will be there and this horizontal plane is below the XY line after rotation. We know this because from points and lines we are studying all this. So I won't go in depth again with the VP and HP. So assume this plane is like this, in the vertical plane like this, in the VP means like this. So from there, if you are seeing this one, what you are able to see? Its shape you are able to see. Got it? So this shape, from there we are able to see. We will draw this hexagon shape like this. Okay, this is one thing. Then if this plane is in the VP, then if you see from the top, what you are able to see from the top? Only one line like this. If you see from the top, only one line will be visible. So that line we will draw here. If it is in the vertical plane, so top view will be coming here. Got it? Like this, plane is in the VP, so top view will come on the XY lines. If the plane is in front of VP, same position like this, if it is in front of VP, how much it is in front, that much comes down. So another case you can see, if it is in front of VP, it will come like this. Okay, suppose the plane is on horizontal plane, resting by its surface on horizontal plane like this. Okay, any position you can rotate. So what you are able to see from there, from front, if you are seeing, you are able to see only one line. If it is above HP, the line will come somewhere here. If it is resting on HP, so line is on the horizontal plane, so the line will come like this. So this is what front view. Here this was front view. Now if you see the hexagon from top, what you are able to see? You are able to see its entire surface. So if you see from the top, this surface is visible to you. See. Like this. Okay, so this top view we will rotate like this and the surface comes here. So this is how, if it is resting on HP, its surface will be visible. Note down this, if it is resting by its surface on HP, the shape of the object, hexagon, pentagon, whatever, is visible from the top like this. If it is in the VP or in front of VP like this, then shape of this object will be visible from front, which falls above the XY line. This is one thing. Now suppose if they are telling the object is in the VP or in front of VP with one condition, that the edge AB, this is the edge AB, this one already I have marked here, is parallel to HP, means like this. Suppose in case if they are saying this edge AB is perpendicular to HP, this edge AB you can take it as this one line, HAB should be perpendicular to HP, means like this, vertical line parallel to HP, line inclined to HP, line perpendicular to HP. This I have explained in the projection of lines basics. Okay, that video I will put it in I button, you can check it there. Now if a line is parallel to HP like this, or edge is parallel to HP, means this line is parallel to HP, so this will come. If they say you this edge or any one edge should be perpendicular to HP. Now the edge, you assume it as a line. Line perpendicular HP means like this. Line inclined to HP like this. Line parallel to HP like this. Now if they say you, one edge of the hexagon should be perpendicular to HP means like this. So that edge, we will treat it as a line. So if they say you, hexagon H is perpendicular to HP means the hexagon shape will come like this, which is here, in this way. So it doesn't mean if edge is vertical, this shape you will get. If edge is parallel to HP means horizontal, you will get this. Here also similarly, if they say you, this is this one, right? Here this edge AB is perpendicular to VP. Perpendicular to VP, this one. Parallel to VP, this one. Inclined to VP, like this. Now here in this case, HAB, if you see here, HAB I will write here also, HAB. Now in this case, HAB, it is this one, HAB. In the top view it is like this. Earlier this was here, so top view HAB we got like this. Okay. Now the same edge you see A and B, if you keep it like this. Now what is this edge position with respect to VP? The edge is perpendicular to VP like this. Rest of the diagram is this one, remaining diagram. Are you able to understand? Once I will repeat in brief. Edge AB is parallel to horizontal plane. So line is parallel to horizontal plane like this. So like that, edge AB is parallel to HP like this, you need to assume. Okay. So front view will come like this. If they say you, edge AB should be perpendicular to HP means like this, then the edge AB should be straight like this. Whenever you are telling edge, then you should imagine this one like this. Similarly here, HAB should be perpendicular to VP means HAB, you take it perpendicular to VP like this. So from top, if you see, the HAB comes like this. This is HAB. In the same way, if they are saying HAB should be parallel with respect to VP, this is VP parallel. If you put HAB with respect to VP as a parallel like this, HAB parallel to VP like this, then in the top view you will be getting like this the image. So hexagon you will be getting in this way. Got it? So edge may be perpendicular to VP, this case. Edge may be horizontal to VP, this is the case, or parallel to VP. Similarly, edge parallel to HP, this is the case. Edge perpendicular to HP, this is the case. With respect to HP, if they are talking about, this is parallel to HP, perpendicular to HP. These are the lines. Similarly, edge parallel to VP, this one. Edge perpendicular to VP, this one. You understand these terms and the basic diagram. Okay. Next thing is, this is some terminology we have seen. Now in the question, what are the things they will ask? I will tell you. They will give you above HP and the surface is visible from the front. So they may give you surface is making some inclination with respect to VP like this, they will give you. Or else if it is in HP like this, this surface, they may also tell you this surface is making some inclination with respect to HP like this. This is surface parallel, this is surface inclined, this is surface perpendicular to HP, same as line. Similarly here, surface parallel to VP or in front of VP or inside the VP, that is different. Surface parallel to VP, surface inclined to VP, surface is perpendicular to VP like this. Okay. Now if you see, assume this as horizontal plane, this as vertical plane. If you put any plane like this, means the plane is perpendicular to VP, like inclination then perpendicularity. Here also with respect to HP, parallel, inclined, perpendicular. In this present situation, how I am holding this plane is perpendicular to both HP as well as VP. So from front if you see, you will be getting one line, and from top if you see, here also you will be getting one line only. Okay. Question, they may give you two things. One is, as I said, surface inclination with respect to HP or surface inclination with respect to VP. So one thing is surface inclination with either HP or VP, depends upon the given question. This is one thing. Second thing, edge inclination with HP or Vp, like this. Suppose this surface is inclined to HP like this, then it is resting by some edge, that is this edge AB. So with respect to Vp, this edge AB, now you should assume it as a line. With respect to Vp, this edge AB, that is this edge AB, you take it as a pen. With respect to Vp, how it is? Is it parallel? Is it inclined? Or is it this edge perpendicular to Vp? Whereas surface is making with respect to horizontal plane, that is one thing over. If surface is making inclination, with HP, then edge will make inclination with Vp. Remember this. If surface is making inclination with Vp, general thing I am telling, tricks, then the edge will make inclination with Vp. Sometimes in rare cases, suppose if you have circle, so circle you may have one diameter, okay. This diameter, assume if it is A and B, so only one entity, it may be with HP, same thing we may be with Vp if they are not talking about, okay. Some rare cases, surface is perpendicular to both Vp and HP, then this is some some exception case. It will be like this, front view one line, top view. This is the general trick while solving problem, okay. Some other extraordinary problems will be there where this tricks may not be useful, but generally this will be helpful. Whenever you have surface inclination with HP, then you'll be having edge inclination with Vp. This two things I have kept. If you have surface inclination with respect to Vp, then edge inclination will be having with HP. Suppose if they have not mentioned anything related to edge, then definitely they will mention related to corner. Any corner. Assume this is edge, this is corner. Either edge or corner they will mention. Okay, this is one thing. Suppose second trick I will give you, this is number one, and second thing I will put it here only. Surface inclination assume any inclination as 30 degrees, then if they have given edge inclination as something 45 degrees, so while solving problem, what you need to do, you need to assume surface inclination, whatever is given, that you need to assume 0 degrees, and whatever edge inclination is given, this you need to assume 90 degrees. This is mandatory. This is our assumption to start the problem. Later on we will restore the angles. Surface angle you need to assume 0, edge angle you need to assume 90 degrees. This is the basic principle. Irrespective of the position of the object, whether it is placed in HP or whether it is placed in VP, this assumption is mandatory. After that we will give original angles. While giving original angles also, one rule we have, first we will restore the original angle, this one. So surface first, second edge. Surface angle we are putting instead of 30, 0 for assumption or first step. Edge angle 45 or anything, we are making it 90 degree for first step. After that, in second step, first angles we need to restore at the end of the problem. So which angle you will restore first? First preference to be given for surface. Surface angle you will give it back, you will restore 30, then in the next step, edge angle you will restore original 45. Got it? These are some basics. So in the next coming questions I will solve projection of planes problems, so you can check out my next problem, projection of planes, if you have understood the basics, or if you have any doubts, please put it comment, and if you solve or watch my other videos related to projection of planes where I will solve some problems, there in the i button you can check it out. So this is all in this video. Please like, subscribe and share my channel, okay. In the next video we will see how to solve projection of planes problems, okay. Thanks for watching everyone.